I'm going to show you this really simple country dessert because it's the only kind of desserts I make. It has a fluff on it that comes off the tree. And just by wiping the quince, I actually cook these whole. I don't peel them, I don't seed them. I just cook to every quince 1 cup of sugar, 1 cup of water, and 1 lemon. And you want to make a syrup. Can you see how beautiful and red these are? And the syrup? I'll cut this open for you, and you'll see that it's really quite pale and sort of almost a cross between an apple and a pear. But that's the colour that it goes just from a long cooking process, nothing more than that. There you are, very, very close to an apple and a pear. They take about 4 or 5 hours to cook whole, and you just, every time you go past the pan, you turn them over again. The more you turn them over, the more the colour comes right through to the centre. If I were using young quinces, I would have left the skin on, but these are the old quinces right at the very end. So in fact, after they've cooked, and not before, after, I've taken the peel off and the core out and just cut them up in quarters as you might do apples and then made slices out of them. The prunes, they've just been cooked in a bit of sherry and lemon juice. Now they mightn't look that attractive, but by the time they're pureed, all they do is become a paste. It's nothing more than that. We're going to bake off the pastry first. Now this is puff pastry, rough puff pastry. So it's just a good buttery pastry which we've rolled out, and we've had it resting for quite some time and pricked it all over. I don't want it to rise up too much, so I'm going to put it in the very hot oven, and then as it rises I'm going to dampen it down with a tea towel because I want the flavour of the buttery puff without a great deal of rising. So that will go into the oven. We want this butteriness of the puff, but I don't want it to be so high. Now be careful not to burn yourself when you do this. Nice thick tea towel. Now it still needs more cooking because we don't want it to be stodgy here. It's still a bit stodgy, but for my taste, I don't want it very much browner. So I might just turn the oven down. You need the oven very high to start off puff pastry, but we can turn it down now and just finish that off. Well, the pastry is cooked now, and this is the prune with the specks of lemon that's been cooked in the sherry, and we're just going to use a spoon or a spatula. So that's pretty well got it. Just tidy up the edges there. Now I'm going to just take these quinces, and see, each quarter has been cut into slices for me, and I'm just going to lay them as if I were laying those tiles on the roof. This is the finished dessert. Now the last thing I would do to that before serving would be to glaze it with the syrup that you saw the quinces sitting in. And either serve them with a creme anglaise, which is just a good homemade custard, or something as simple as creme fraiche.